Good morning and welcome to the first meeting of Session 6 of the Equalities, Human Rights and Civil Justice Committee. I am Alexander Stewart, MSP for Mid Scotland and Fife. And as I am the oldest member of the committee, I have the pleasure of convening the first two agenda items. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome all members to the committee, and I look forward to working with you all. Before we move to the first item of agenda, can I ask that all individuals present ensure that their mobile phones are switched to silent? Item one is declarations of interest. Each of us has to declare any interests that we have that are relevant to the work of this committee. And I will go first, and then I will go alphabetically through members of the committee. I have myself no relevant interests to declare for the work of this committee. If I can now move on to the members of the committee, and if I can start with Karen Adams. Karen?
Good morning. I have no relevant interests to declare for this committee. Thank you.
Thank you. Maggie Chapman?
Good morning, Alexander. Thank you. I am currently still employed by Edinburgh Rape Crisis Centre, and that might be relevant to some of the programme for work that we discuss later on. But that employment ends on the 30th of June.
Thank you, Maggie. Pam Duncan-Glancy.
Hello, good morning. I have a couple of interests to register this morning, the first of which is that I worked for Public Health Scotland until the 11th of May. I don't work there anymore, but my employment ended as I got elected. And also in my voluntary register, but I think it's important to mention it now, I served on the board of Engender Scotland for 3 years. That period came to an end at the end of last year. And between the period 2009 and 2015, I was a policy officer for Inclusion Scotland.
Thank you very much indeed, Pam. Joe Fitzpatrick.
Morning, Alexander. I have no interest to declare. Thanks.
Thank you, Joe. Pam Gossel.
Morning, Alexander. I have no relevant interest to declare for this committee.
Thank you, Pam. And finally, Fulton McGregor.
Thanks, Alexander. Yes, I would like to alert members to my voluntary register of interest as a registered social worker with the SSSC, and I was a practicing social worker prior to my election in 2016. But I've maintained my registration during that period and currently.
Thank you very much indeed. Item number two is the choice of the convener. The committee have agreed, the Parliament has agreed, that only members from the Scottish National Party are eligible for nomination as convener of this committee. And I understand that Joe Fitzpatrick is the party's nominee. Do we agree as a committee to choose Joe Fitzpatrick as our convener? We do. You're all nodding. Thank you. Congratulations, Joe, on your appointment as the convener of this committee. And I now hand the remainder of the meeting over to you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Alexander. And thanks, everyone, for your support in nomination to become convener of the committee. I look forward to working with all of you over the coming years. I think this is one of the most important committees in the Parliament. It's a committee which I think has shown the benefits of devolution, and I think particularly in the last Parliament committee showed that even in the difficult times of COVID, the importance of engaging with the population of Scotland. And I think, although I was only a member towards the end, Alexander has been a member throughout the last Parliament and will be aware of the engagement the committee took forward. I think that's something we should continue to do. Obviously, the committee's remit has now expanded, and I think that is a good thing, but clearly it means that we will have some challenges in terms of making sure we manage our time, but really look forward to working with you all in the years going forward. So the next item is for us to choose our deputy convener. So the Parliament has agreed that only members of the Scottish Green Party are eligible for nomination as deputy convener of this committee. I understand that Maggie Chapman is the party's nominee for the post. So do we agree to choose Maggie Chapman as our deputy convener? I am seeing nods all round, so congratulations, Maggie, on your election as deputy convener of the committee. We now move on to item 4 of the agenda, and that item is to make a decision on whether to discuss our work programme, item 5, in private. Is that agreed? Okay, seeing nods all round again, so thank you very much. We'll now move over to the Microsoft Teams platform, and I invite members to disconnect from BlueJeans and leave this meeting, and then open the separate link to MS Teams provided by the clerks. So that ends this public part of the meeting, and we move into private. Thank you.